Dear friends, I am Parvinda from West Highlander and I welcome you all in this video where I will be speaking about study options at New Zealand Institute of Skills and Technology, T. Pukenga. I will be speaking about the study options for students who have done their 10 plus 2 and are looking forward to study in New Zealand. I would also be speaking about the study options for students who have done their graduation and would now like to study in New Zealand. So friends, keep watching for complete information. There are a range of course options if you would like to study in New Zealand Institute of Skills and Technology, T. Pukenga. If you are a student who has done his 10 plus 2 and is looking forward to study in New Zealand, then you may either choose to do a diploma or a bachelor's degree. Depending on the career outcomes you wish to have, as well as your budget for study in New Zealand, and whether you would like to enjoy the post-study work visa facility, you may choose to do a diploma program or a bachelor's degree. The range of course options is huge. The students may choose to do a program in engineering, a program in IT, hospitality, tourism, health science, nursing. So the course range is huge. Depending on your academic profile, you may choose to do a diploma or a bachelor's degree in either of these subjects. The entry requirements for diploma programs and bachelor's degree are slightly different. If you would like to do a 1 year of diploma program, then you need to have good percentage of marks in your 10 plus 2 as well as an IELTS band score of overall 5.5 with no band less than 5. For 2 years of diploma program at level 6 of New Zealand qualification framework, the IELTS band requirement is of overall 6 with no band less than 5.5. For most of the bachelor's degree, the students may get admission with a band score of overall 6 with no band less than 5.5. Applicants here must note that the English language requirement for certain courses like nursing and health sciences may be higher. Hence, the students are highly encouraged to check with the exact course requirements they wish to study in New Zealand. Moreover, the post-study work visa facility would depend on the choice of your course. For bachelor's degree, any bachelor's degree, be it be a bachelor's in IT, a bachelor's in business, the completion of the program would make you eligible to apply for a 3 years of post-study work visa. But if you choose to do a diploma program, then the students must take care that if they would like to avail the post-study work visa facility, then the diploma program must be listed in the green list. If the diploma program is not in the green list, the student would not be able to apply for post-study work visa after the completion of the course. For students who have done their graduation and are looking forward to study in New Zealand, there are also various course options. The students may choose to do a master's degree, a postgraduate diploma, or a graduate diploma. Depending on your academic profile and any work experience you may have, you may choose to do a course in engineering, a course in IT, hospitality, tourism, health sciences, nursing. Again, the course range is huge to choose from. Applicants must choose a course which is a logical and a relevant progression of their current academic and any work experience profile they may have. Furthermore, choosing a master's degree or a postgraduate diploma or a graduate diploma would depend on the choice of the student. Master's degree in New Zealand are generally of 1 to 2 years in duration. To get admission into a master's program, the students must have IELTS band score of overall 6.5 with no band less than 6 and a good percentage of marks. For postgraduate diplomas also, the entry requirements are almost similar. For graduate diplomas, the IELTS requirement is overall 6 with no band less than 5.5 in any of the 4 modules. Applicants again must note that they must check with the exact entry requirements, as the English language requirements or academic requirements for some courses may be high. If you choose to do a master's program, then after the successful completion of the course, you would be eligible to apply for a 3 years of post-study work visa. For postgraduate diplomas, the duration of the post-study work visa is for 1 year. If you choose to do a graduate diploma, then you would only be eligible for a post-study work visa if the graduate diploma is in the green list. So take care while choosing the graduate diploma if you would like to avail the post-study work visa after completion of your course in New Zealand. Friends, I hope you find this video useful. For any query you may have about study in New Zealand, please contact West Highlander. We are a team of experienced and expert counselors who can help you throughout the process. Thank you.